an SBA loan? A lot of people have questions regarding SBA loans, so I want to explain everything. I want to explain the process, the procedure, how to use it, because it really is a great tool to help you grow your business. All right, so an SBA loan, all the SBA does, a small business association, is it works with several banks. All right, this is the boring stuff. We'll get to the good stuff in a minute. But the SBA works with several banks and says, hey, this is the process. If you do everything exactly like this, we will guarantee 80% of the value of that loan. So banks want to write these loans. All right. Now, they have to check a lot of boxes. There's a lot of hurdles to go through. All right. That's one of the drawbacks to SBA loans. But the SBA is really the gold standard. It's always going to be the cheapest and the longest loan you can get for your business. Okay. So the way it works is they typically go out, depending on what type of SBA loan it is, about 10 years. Okay, so an SBA 7A is working capital, but it can also be used to buy a building. It could be used to consolidate debt. It could be used to start a business. And it could be used to get a bunch of equipment. However, if you are buying a building with a 7A, there are banks that will go out 20, 25 years. Okay, that's your general all-purpose SBA loan. And the good thing about a 7A is that if you utilize a 7A, there's no prepayment penalty. Alright? The other type of SBA loan is what's called a 504. And a 504 is primarily used to purchase a building. With a 504, there is a prepayment penalty. Alright? And it does automatically go out a lot longer. But let's dig into these and let's really go into how to utilize it. My preference, being in small business finance for the past 14 years, I would tell you I would always choose a 7A. A 7A you can utilize and do anything with that you can do a 504 with. Okay? In my opinion, that's the way I would go. Now, what do you need to get started? If you are trying to start a business, the only time the SBA will really approve you, it's very tough if you're not an SBA approved franchise. If you're an SBA approved franchise, you have all your paperwork, right? You have all your projections, and it's already approved, right? It's just a matter of having the credit and having the assets or the collateral to get the final determination, all right? So typically with an SBA loan, if you're going over $350,000, you need to have pledgeable assets that'll cover the note, all right? So let's dig into that really quick so you understand. Let's say that you're taking on a $500,000 SBA loan. Okay, at $500,000, you need to have pledgeable assets of $500,000. What does that mean? It means they're going to take your personal financial statement and they're going to look, they're going to take the value of all your assets and then they're going to value them at 80%. So let's say you have $2 million worth of assets. All right, they're going to get valued at $1.6 million. Let's say you have total debt or liabilities on those assets of $1 million. Well, they're going to subtract the value of 80% by the current liabilities, and then you have $600,000 of pledgeable assets. All right, so what does that mean to you? That means you'll probably get approved for that loan, right? You have to have strong credit, okay? I can't stress that enough. So typically, they want to see 700 credit. And then, let's say you're not starting a business. If you're using an SBA loan, it really should be either start a business, to buy a business, to consolidate debt, to buy equipment. Those are really the best, and to buy a building. Those are the best use cases for an SBA loan because it's a long-term line. Each one of those things is you use it over a longer period of time versus getting inventory or getting supplies or marketing. Those are all short-term uses. That should really be like a line of credit. So when you're going for the SBA, let's talk about, certain requirements. If you are just looking for a working capital SBA, okay, they're going to look at your profit margins for the most part. There's only one program that's in beta right now that we're working with that will go on top line revenue. But primarily speaking, an SBA loan is underwritten based off your profit margins and your credit and your time in business. So they typically ask you for 2 to 3 years of business and personal returns. They want to see your personal financial statement. And the rule of thumb here is, if you're a profitable business, you should be able to get approved. If you are profitable for $45,000, if you have $45,000 in profit, you should be able to get approved for $350,000 over 10 years. All right, if you have more, you can get approved for more. All right, but generally speaking, every $45,000 in profit, you should be able to qualify for $350,000 over 10 years. That's how that scenario works. Now, if you're buying a business, they're going to analyze your current business, how profitable is it, and the business you're buying. So the more profitable the business you're buying, the more assets you have, that's all going to help and get you a higher likelihood of getting approved. All right? Now, there's a lot of ins and outs here. I understand that. Any questions you have, you can come to me. The next thing I want to go over is what's the process like? All right? The process, I tell everybody, it usually takes about 30 to 120 days. So if you're looking for a working capital one, that'll go a little quicker. If you're trying to buy a building or a business, I always say have 120 days to close. Why? Because typically if you are buying a business, you need the purchase and sale done prior. If you're buying a building, they need the purchase agreement. If you're starting a franchise, they need the LOI, meaning they need the letter of intent to lease. These are all things that you can't start the process, the SBA loan process, without having. So you want to have those ducks in a row, and then come to someone like me or your local SBA processing bank and get that process started. Right? The quicker you have all your documents together, the easier that note's going to be. All right? And that process is going to be. If you have any questions about this, please feel free to reach out. I'm here to support you in any way I can, even if it's just information. All right, I appreciate you for tuning in, and I will catch you on the next one.